I would call myself a product designer, not a UX designer, because so many people don't understand what UX designers do, and then we don't get invited to meetings early on. So these days, Silicon Valley tech companies are changing our titles from UIUX designers to product designers. At the end of the day, we're all designing for the products. Hey everyone, I'm Aliana, and I will tell you about if I started my design career this year, what would I do? I would learn Figma ASAP, not Sketch, not Adobe XD, not Webflow. Figma is the mainstream design software at its time, and it is so powerful that you don't have to learn too much other things. And I would start by recreating the wireframes of existing products. And I'm not just talking about things you use on a daily basis, like Instagram. I'm also talking about B2B products, like Salesforce. In this way, I can quickly learn how existing products organize their design, and also learn how to visualize ideas quickly with wireframe. Next, I will go to low fidelity prototype, so this time focusing on the features, and then create multiple screens and try to link those screens together, so that when you click one button, takes you to the next page, click another button, take you to another page. And next, I will do high fidelity prototyping. High fidelity design is all about pixel perfect, so bring out the OCD inside you. And I will give you an example from my student in Fast Track UX course. This is the YouTube home screen, and this is my student's work. Again, this is YouTube production, this is my student's mockup. I will highly suggest you to duplicate similar screens. In this way, we can learn so much about UI design and Figma. If you put your design into one frame, and then put the screenshot into another frame, and then play the prototype, if you click left and right, and couldn't tell much difference, then your Figma skill is good enough to go to the next step. When it comes to Figma, these three skills are very important. How to use the alignment tools on the top right panels, how to use components, and how to use auto layout. These three tools can streamline your high fidelity design process. Now going to a non-technical suggestion, consider relocating. I will give you an analogy. What is the best way to learn English? The answer is to move to an English-speaking country. You can learn so much about English compared to years of taking classes. And similar things are happening in tech. There are cities where everyone moved to create startups and tech products. So opportunities and networks are very different across different cities. I've lived in San Francisco, I've visited Bangalore, India, and I've also lived in Seattle. And I can say that these three cities have great networks in tech and lots of opportunities. The next one is to learn design systems. I am so surprised seeing so many bootcamps that cost thousands of dollars don't even teach design system in depth. I get it that most design systems are in-house, but there are a lot of resources you can find on Figma community. And for example, you should check out Ant Design and Shopify's Polaris. I will include all this information in the downloadable guide in the description. You can always check out that later. But here's what you can do with design systems. Just think of it as templates. You can go on Google and then search for any product, take a screenshot, and then try to use the Ant design system to build that page. It shall look totally different just because you use a different design system, but all the features shall be there. That's how you practice using it. Because in tech companies, we don't design too many components, we use design systems. After you lay some great foundation on your Figma skills, you can go ahead and try to start your first project. Choosing the topic is so important. Please, 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 do not design a food delivery app. Do not design a ride-sharing app. And do not design an e-commerce app. There are hundreds of designers at DoorDash, Uber, and Amazon. If you think you can single-handedly beat those companies in 1 month, you shall be hiring people, not applying for jobs. So this is what I suggest you to do. Find an established product out there. Honestly, for first project, it's easier if you start like a B2C app, something you are using on a daily basis. And then you choose one specific feature and then make that feature better. Better in the sense that the user will feel better or it reduces the friction of the user flow. You also need to justify how it's going to make more money for the company. I remember like a few years ago, I did a video on how I redesigned Airbnb's wishlist feature. You can do something similar. I also suggest you to write up a PRD, product request document. You can ask ChatGPT if you want to. This is the job of a product manager, but now you are your own product manager, you need to do it yourself. I suggest you to organize your Figma file this way. The template is also in the link in the description. And please, please, please document your design. Annotate why you make certain design iterations. I also suggest you to put the latest design to the first page. Next, what I would do is searching for a client project while building my portfolio. You might ask, how do you search for a client project without a portfolio? Remember I told you to organize your Figma file? If your Figma file is organized enough, you can literally just share that file and tell people, hey, this is an example of a project that I'm working on. They will go in there, they will see all the iterations and annotations. And the first page is your high fidelity design. And then if it's good enough, let's say I'm the recruiter, there's really no need for me to watch a polished write-up version of a portfolio, you know? Also, when I say client project, I don't mean using resume and portfolio to apply for a job at Apple. I mean going to networking event and then outreach to smaller companies, smaller projects, and then asking to do some redesigns for them. So here's an outreaching tip. When you outreach and say you can offer UX design or product design service, please offer value in this email. You can definitely be very authentic and say that I would love to apply what I just learned into a client project, but please tell them how you can help them to improve their product. So if, let's say, this person has a landing page selling some product, then you can say, I can help you to improve the landing page to increase the conversion rate by around 5%. You can even record a long video saying that I'm just going through your homepage and I found some areas that could be further improved. For example, you're using accent color a bit too much, which makes it difficult for the audience to focus on the key call to action. Overall, I think I can reorganize this website for you so it's in a flow that's more natural. And I think the outcome of this is that you will have more people buying your product. And while you're doing this outreach and searching for this client project, you can spend the other part of your time designing your portfolio. I would suggest three tools to consider: Figma, Notion, and Framer. You can do a slideshow type of presentation within Figma. Literally, there are tons of presentations out there in Figma, but I would suggest to keep it under 10 pages. So you can talk about this project you've just done, process of it, the result, the before, the after, and then the impact, and then your contact information. Now, let's say your outreach is not going well. You've tried different strategies and it's not working. Then what I suggest you to do is improve your UIUX design skill by creating another project. It could be another project about designing a new feature for an existing product, or it could be a passion project, building a platform from zero to one. And you shall keep improving on your personal project until you find a client project. And once you find a client project, focus your main time on doing that client project. So here are just a few tips. If you find a client project, define the scope early on, especially define what is outside the scope. You don't want to work on everything. You want to work on one thing that can lead to a clear metric of success. Ask for user testing capacity early on and don't say like, hey, can we do some user testing? Because sometimes they don't even know how to do user testing. So instead just say, can I have 10 emails of your current user? Because that's all you need to start scheduling for user testing. Ask 10 emails, it's much easier for you, and in the long run, it's also beneficial for them. And once you feel like this project is around 80% done, put that into your portfolio. Don't wait until a project is completely done, because client project can never be finished. There's no such thing as completely done. There's always something that comes up. And now that you have a client project, I will suggest you to bring this into a portfolio that's yourname.com. Use Framer. Framer is an AI website building tool. It's very new, but it can make your portfolio look really well. And compared to other things like Webflow, it's easier to use and more similar to a design kind of feeling. But compared to like the old version of Wix, it's also much easier to make it responsive. It does have some learning curve though. And once you have client project, put your client project into a portfolio and then use that as the case study to present in job interviews. And next, you can find for a legit product design job in big tech companies. But here's something I want to tell you. It's not easy, because there's a lot of people out there competing for the same thing. Consider a contractor role first. I did a contractor role at eBay, and I can tell you that the project I worked on is completely the same as full-time employees, and sometimes even harder. To get contractor roles at bigger companies is easier than directly going for a full-time role. You can work for 6 months for Google, another 6 months for Microsoft. You can even learn a lot by switching companies early on, because you get access to all different design systems and learning about the strengths and weaknesses of different companies. Don't go yet. The most important part has not even started. I have some words that I really want to share with you, and these are exactly the words I needed to hear a few years ago. But no one told me these, but now you get it for free. The first thing is be patient. It's like hearing from your mom, isn't it? The entire YouTube platform is making everyone feel more rushed. like the content pacing, every content creator trying to catch your attention on every second. Yes, because we need to work for the algorithm. If you live in the middle of this video, I get paid way less and my video cannot even be seen by more people. So if you see videos like how I became a UIUX designer under 3 months, please keep in mind that this content creator probably also have 10 years of graphic design experience. Also, if this person understand how to create a content that has thousands of views, plus making the thumbnail so good that you want to click into it, it's very likely that this person can also land a job faster than the majority of us because some skills can transfer. But we really shouldn't design our life based on another person's timeline. Also, when you are setting a career goal, think about whether the goal you're setting is within your control. This is something my coach taught me last week because I'm in this sales and marketing phase of selling my fast track UX course. And I told my coach that my goal is to find 1,000 new students. Then I realized that I'm continuously burned out every day because whether you buy my course or not is completely up to you. I changed my goal to setting up 2 sustainable sales channels. That's something within my control and that's something I can do. Similar things happened when I was trying to break into tech as a UX designer. Because my goal used to be get into Google as a UX designer. That is a great thing to manifest for, but it's a horrible goal to set because whether Google accept me or not is completely up to Google. Something that's up to me is how many applications I want to send out every day, how many people I want to reach out every day, what strategy that I can use. Focusing what's under your control can reduce so much stress for you and bring you so much more clarity. Also in business, we often talk about this concept of red ocean versus blue ocean. It's just a fancy way of saying that a red ocean is a market that's extremely competitive, and if your strategy of doing something is competing in this red ocean full of people, it's going to be difficult. However, you can explore a blue ocean, which is a new market or a less competitive market. For example, in a time like this, I heard a lot of people say that it's extremely competitive to break into tech because most companies are firing people and not hiring people. Well, think about what companies do when they have less headcount, but they still need people to finish their work. They will hire contractors. So in a time like this, contractor jobs still exist, and you can also reach out to staffing agencies to get into Google, eBay, big tech as a contractor. Another thing that's blue ocean is building a personal brand. When I was trying to apply for jobs, sending resume is the slowest way and the least effective way because I have a personal brand and people see me and trust me more because of my personal brand on YouTube. So I started to create more videos that offer value that showcase what I can do. And in that way, I attract clients instead of me chasing after clients. And so many more opportunities came my way and those opportunities are not even available on job posting websites. I've said a lot today, so if you want a kindly reminder, I've put everything into a downloadable guide. Just click the link and you will get it for free. Meanwhile, if you want me to take you through your UX design transformation, check out Fast Track UX. I'm working full-time every day for this course. Thank you so much for watching. I wish you all the best with your career and I will see you in this video.